Science. The 19th century saw many advances for man. The Industrial Revolution, sanitation, medicine, and of course, the construction of the MCB building at UCT. Nobody knows for sure who these brave pioneers were, but one thing is clear. This is a monument to science. Our adventure begins here at Lab 402, whose excellence in science is arguably unrivaled here or anywhere else for that matter. One might say that with almost indefinite funding, anything is possible. Every team needs a leader, and Lab 402 is no different. Meet G.G. Lindsey. His never-die spirit and controversial techniques have earned him the nickname The Bear. Obtaining a PhD in metabolism at the University of Sussex and an avid off-road rally driver, Professor Lindsey was the obvious choice for studying that nebulous peptide, HSP12. It's hard work to be a scientist. The days are long. Let us observe one such morning, bright and early at 9:45. The first to arrive is Vanessa Shamrock. In answer to the question, can woman do science? Vanessa had this to say.
If I throw a stick, will you leave?
Miss Shamrock, now conducting her research into ethanol tolerance of GM Saccharomyces using a plasmid construct containing a de novo promoter cassette to hyperexpress HSV12 to plasticize oligosugarcytes within the sugar cell wall. Using such techniques as vector cloning, PCR, this lovable scamp has won a place in all our hearts. It's 10:15, and time to meet our next up-and-coming scientist. As a living relic of prehistoric man, Johan brings more than just his personality to Lab 402. Festive music of the genre death metal accompanies him during his research into post-dioxic shifts, nutrient limitation, and aeration. As one of his minor sideline projects, Johan hopes to clarify some of the more subtle aspects of HSP12, such as its function. Fellow researchers speak jokingly of Johan, only to run and hide in his approach. Quiet and shy, we find Evan Robinson hard at work on his project. After initial success as a European pop idol, Evan thought that he could do with some fun, and steered his career towards science. Deciding that if anyone is going to play God, he'd rather it be him, Evan has controversially attached nature's blueprint, or DNA, from jellyfish to yeast heat shock protein 26 in order to make it glow in the dark. When asked what relevance such experiments would have for science, he comments,
"That's pretty cool, isn't it?"
Oh, look who's just popped by. It's our friend Gavin. As a visitor from the faraway land of Durbanville, Gavin's feisty cheer and gunslinging antics are always a hit in 402. An example to people everywhere, Gavin easily balances his life as a professional stuntman with his scientific career investigating profitable proteins from the acacia tree. It's 11:30, and PhD heavyweights Rob and Andrew are running at full force. There's little room for error at the top. How's the view up there? Orphaned as a child on the streets of Calcutta, Rob was taken in by Sister Catherine at one of the many Catholic missionary posts. Surrounded by hardship, Rob was powerless to help his foster mother as she died from a lack of vitamin B. Sadly, only months later, scientists discovered that Marmite, made up of yeast extract, was the richest source of vitamin B on the planet. Rob knew then that he would devote the rest of his days to making sure that others would never know his pain. As a leading authority on the HSP12 stress response, nobody is more qualified in the chemistry of Marmite than him. Andrew Kessler, some say, may not have been born. It is simply assumed that he congealed in a gutter somewhere. This may explain his chaotic workbench and nightmarish lack of observation for the Safety First protocol. Spending his time deep in thought, Andrew has managed to construct many theories, many of which are coherent, and some about HSP12. As a motivated, hard-working individual, Andrew has committed to memory the molecular weights of tris, NaCl, and glucose. His pastimes include extreme science and fun with things that burn. Well, it's 12 o'clock and time for this busy crew to head off home. None may be truly aware of how much we have come to rely on scientists. From molecular modelers to simple microarray analysis, the world is once again safe thanks to Lab 402. Until next time, goodbye! I'm
I'm an outlaw.
I'm an outlaw.
Quick on the draw.
Quick on the draw.
Someone you never seen before.
You've never seen.
And I got a motherfucker that come in my face. I got something wrong.
I got something wrong.
And I got it from home.